Hi! Judging by some comments on my videos on radioactivity, there seems to be a misconception. It is a common belief that you can't detect uranium, thorium or other alpha radiation emitters unless you have a Geiger counter that can detect the alpha particles. Seems logical, but it is not the whole story, as I will demonstrate in this video. I will use this new device that cannot detect alpha radiation. However, unlike all of my Geiger counters, this tiny inexpensive scintillation counter should be able to do spectrometry. If that is true, I can, for the first time in my life, detect not only if something is radioactive, but also why it is radioactive, since different radioactive elements have different gamma radiation spectrums. Like, are these mushrooms radioactive from natural sources or from nuclear fallout? Let's find out! Only handle radioactive samples if you know what you're doing. This smoke detector is of the ionization type. It contains a tiny amount of a radioactive element called americium, more specifically the radioisotope americium-241. This is known as an alpha emitter. Its atomic nucleus contains a lot of protons, 95 of them, that repel each other due to their positive electric charge. This makes the nucleus unstable, and at some point it will emit an alpha particle consisting of two protons and two neutrons. By getting rid of two protons, americium has decayed into another element, neptunium, with 93 protons in the nucleus. All of this is undetectable by the radiocode 101, since the emitted alpha particle is shielded by metal. The alpha particle cannot even penetrate the plastic cover of the smoke detector, or on the scintillation counter itself. So it should not react to the alpha-emitting americium inside the smoke detector. Let's test it. I'd say it is freaking out. Clearly, it is detecting the radioactivity of americium. How does it do that, if the source inside emits alpha radiation, which is impossible for it to detect? Well, this overview of the decay isn't the full story. Just like electrons orbiting the nucleus, the protons and neutrons in the nucleus can be at a higher energy level than the ground state of the nucleus. After emitting an alpha particle, the neptunium nucleus is not in its ground state. It is in an excited state. It needs to emit some energy to de-excite into its relaxed ground state. It does this by emitting electromagnetic energy, a high energy photon, a gamma ray that the radio code can detect. A sensitive Geiger counter will also detect the gamma radiation from the de-exciting neptunium nucleus. However, the radio code has an extra big trick up its sleeve. Not only can it tell if a gamma ray has hit it, it can tell how strong each gamma ray is. The emitted gamma rays from the americium decay can be at different but distinct energy levels. The two most common are at 60 and 26 kilo electron volts, with 60 kilo electron volts being by far the most likely. I have attached the radio code to a laptop to measure the energy of the gamma rays detected. Not the best solution, actually. More info later. But look at that! After just 5 minutes, I see a major and minor photo peak very close to the 60 and 26 kilo electron volts expected from americium decay. The factory calibration may only be off by a few kilo electron volts, which is 0.00 nothing joules. And notice how the 60 kilo electron volts peak is the most common, as predicted. The peak around 26 kilo electron volts perhaps appears higher than americium alone can explain. Probably because this still isn't the full story. Neptunium-237 is radioactive too and decays into protactinium-233. The excited protactinium nuclei emit gamma rays at typically 29 and 86 kilo electron volts, adding to the measured spectrum. Assuming the americium disk was freshly made when this smoke detector was new, back in week 24 of 2009, It can be calculated to contain around 2% neptunium after decaying for 12.5 years. Nice! This is the first time I don't have to trust the label or online sources. I now know for sure that it is americium-241 that makes the smoke detector radioactive. Let's try something without a label. According to my most sensitive Geiger counter, these dried mushrooms are slightly radioactive. But why? Did they pick up some naturally occurring radioactive elements from the ground? Or man-made nuclear fallout? A Geiger counter can't tell me, but perhaps the radio code will. Since we're dealing with a source of weak intensity, I expect it will be harder to distinguish from natural background radiation. I'll therefore measure the natural background radiation at my table first. Well, perhaps I should empty my cupboard first. I have a collection of uranium glass and uranium glazed dishware. Not exactly part of the natural background radiation. Alright, time for a 30 minutes test with no test sources near the sensor. There we go. This is what we can compare the spectrum from the mushrooms with. Will they show other photo peaks? I am especially interested in a wide peak around 662 kilo electron volts, a well-known indicator of nuclear fallout. Wow, after just 10 minutes, I am seeing a peak centered around 662 kilo electron volts that wasn't present in the background measurement. And even one close to 32 keV. These are photopeaks from the radioactive decay of caesium-137 that is not naturally occurring. It is nuclear fallout from an exploded nuclear reactor. Caesium-137 primarily emits beta radiation, but as with americium, there are some other types of emissions that can be detected. I have listed the most common here. So, despite all odds, I now can say for sure that these mushrooms contain radio caesium. Scary and fascinating at the same time. After a short message, I'll attempt something even more challenging for the radio code. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. Thank you so much for helping out. It's really appreciated and important for a niche channel with monthly quality uploads like mine. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link to my Patreon page in the description. Thank you. Alright, as a final experiment, I'll attempt to detect potassium-40. Looking at the stats, it is highly unlikely with a small scintillation crystal. The chance of a gamma ray even being emitted and going in the direction of the sensor and depositing all of its energy inside the small sensor is, well, 0% in round numbers. Still, it is worth a try using a kilogram of potassium chloride and the more refined mobile app. This is how you're supposed to use the radio code. Connected via Bluetooth to your mobile, you can have this dosimeter and gamma spectrometer with you all the time. And believe it or not, after just half an hour, I am pretty sure it detected some gamma rays from potassium-40. There's a photo peak centered at exactly 1461 keV. This is amazing, and why I claim this little device beats all Geiger counters. You simply cannot do this with any Geiger counter. The radio code has more functions than shown so far, but this video is already getting long enough. More info can be found in the link in the description. In a future video, I will try to confirm the labels on these two interesting element samples. Subscribe to unmiss that, and click like if you like the video enough to watch this far. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.